Hey y'all, we're going to do a quick tutorial today on a Minnie Mouse bow. Easter's coming up and a lot of people go to Disney during that time because the kids are out of school. So we're just going to do a quick and simple bow that you can make to go with some outfits. We're going to use the red and white polka dot, which is what Minnie Mouse is known for. Okay, this is a 1.5 inch grosgrain ribbon. This is cut to about 28 inches. Okay, of course, I use my salon clip here for creasing the middle. You need a needle and thread. I use the upholstery thread because it's good and strong. Scissors. And for this one, I'm going to use just a regular lighter instead of the wood-burning tool. You need a glue gun. And also, the coordinating ribbons here, I have 3/8 inch. Now, this is a red and white polka dot. If you just want to get a solid red, that would work as well. And then for her bow, I've got some white satin. You can use white grosgrain or any color you want. This is about a 6 to 6.5 inch piece, and then you also need a coordinating 3/8 inch piece to go around the middle. You need 2 pieces of felt for her ears. This measures this is 1 3/4 inches. Okay, and this is, you know, a good size for what we're going to work with. And then I just have a lined alligator clip to go in the back. Okay, the type of bow we're going to make is called a cheer bow, but you can certainly do the Minnie Mouse ears and bow on any type of bow. Okay. Alright, so basically, and there are a lot of tutorials on how to do this bow, so we're just going to make it real quick. Basically, you get your ribbon and you cross it. You know, it's kind of like an awareness symbol, okay? And then, basically, you kind of just find the middle here and you slide it under until you get something like this, okay? And then you just kind of adjust your loops. And if you're happy with the way they look and they're symmetrical, okay, then you want to get your salon clip. And you may not use a salon clip to crease your bows, but I definitely do. Okay, and so now we want to sew the middle, but just to make sure that our loops are symmetrical, I always just kind of pull them down and see and adjust before I sew them. Okay, and that looks pretty good to me. So I get my needle and thread. Okay, and then I go through the center here in the back. Okay, and then just like in the other videos, we just want to go around a couple of times. I love this salon clip. It just makes creasing your bow in the middle a lot easier. For me, anyway. I don't have the finger strength to crease my bows with my fingers. This is easier to me. Okay, and so we've got our middle wrapped, and then you just simply pull, and then your bow is creased, and then you can take that salon clip off and pull it pretty tight. Okay, and you just want to play around with your loops for a minute. Okay, And just kind of look and adjust, and when you're satisfied, then you just want to tie it off in the back. And I've got my thread all tied up here. Okay, and then you just want to do a knot in the back. Okay, and cut it off. And since I'm using a salon clip, I'm not going to need to keep the thread on there. See, before we used the thread to wrap the barrette in, but I don't do that with my alligator clips. We use an alligator clip. Okay, so this is what we have, and this is just a simple bow. It's not real large like some of the others I make. Okay, now, if you want to stiffen this bow, you can definitely get some hairspray or some stiffen quick and get an old towel and just, you know, spray it or whatever. You do not have to wait for it to dry. Just sit and wait for it to dry. You can get a hairdryer and go over it. I put mine in front of a little table fan, and literally within a minute or two, it dries really well. I do find hairspray dries quicker than the stiffen quick, but you don't have to, you know, let it sit for an hour or whatever, okay? But just for time's sake, we're just gonna go ahead with the tutorial. Okay, now, first thing I wanna do is wrap my middle section here, and that's what I have the red 3/8, the red and white 3/8 ribbon. Okay, so I'll just turn it over to the back and put a little glue. Hold that down and then wrap the center. Go around to the back and adjust. And cut off the excess. And then just glue that little flap down. Okay, hold it. And of course, you know, your bow looks nice just like that with the tails. And of course, at this point, you can go ahead and put your alligator clip. This is a lined alligator clip. All right. So that's what I'm going to do anyway. Doesn't really matter if you put it on now or you put it on last. I'm going to go ahead and put mine on. All right. You just need a strip of glue in the back. And then you can just put that clip on. Hold it down for a second. Okay, and this is what we have so far. Okay. Now, before we get started with the ears, we can go ahead and trim up our tails. Okay. So mine are a little uneven, so what I'm going to do is kind of clip that excess off of this one and then trim this one up a little bit. Okay, and then you can cut these at an angle. What I'm going to do is do what I call a dovetail. Okay, I put both of them together. You see how I did that? I just kind of put one on top of the other and make sure your ends are even. And then you fold it in half. Okay. And then you take your scissors and you want to cut up from this corner, from the outside up. Okay, hopefully you can see that. And just lop it off. Okay, and then that's what you end up with. Okay, now you can take the wood burning tool and go along the edges if you want. I think with this particular thing, it's just a little bit easier to go with a lighter very quickly. Okay, and there are a lot of tutorials where, you know, the lighters are used. Okay, so that's what we have so far with our little tails. Okay, now gets to the decorating, the embellishment. Okay, before we put the embellishment on, we want to make the bow. Okay, and that's why we have the white here. Now, I've just chosen to use the satin, and I'm just going to go over these ends because they're terribly frayed. But you can use grosgrain ribbon, any type of ribbon you want to. Satin is just real easy to work with, in my opinion. Okay, and this is a tuxedo style bow. So what I do is I just kind of bend this ribbon in half to make a crease to tell me where my center point is. Okay, and then I just fold one part over and I go a little bit over the center. Okay, the center is about right here. I overlap just a little bit. And then same thing with this. I overlap just a tad with this one too. Okay. And then I turn it over to the front. And basically I bend it in half. You see how I did that? I just bend it in half at the center. Okay. And then I go down with this side and down with the other side. I fold the two sides down. Okay, and that's what, you know, what you end up with. It's like a little tuxedo bow. Okay. And you can certainly use the salon clip to crease this bow also. But since it's a small bow, I'm able to just crease it like that. Okay, now basically I just stick my needle. I go through the bottom there. Stick my needle in the center. And then I need to cut that little piece off right there. Okay. And then basically you just go around the center a few times. And it doesn't matter that your thread is a different color. You're not going to see that. Okay. Just kind of make sure your loops are the same. All right, and then tie it off in the back. Okay, and then you can clip that off. And I'm gonna clip that little piece off. Okay, and so that's what you have for the Minnie Mouse bow. Okay, and then our little 3/8 piece right here, we're going to glue it around the center. Okay, so I'm going to put a little bit of glue. Okay, and you can wrap it once, but I'm going to wrap it twice since my thread is a different color. And just glue it off in the back, and I'm just going to heat seal this before I glue it down, getting all tangled up here. See this little piece right here? Just, whoa, caught on fire. All right. And that little flap right there, you're just going to glue it down. Okay, like that. All right, and this is our little bow for the Minnie Mouse ears. Okay, now I have found with doing these bows that I actually glue the bow down first, because then it helps me in the placement of my ears. Okay, so let's go ahead and do that. You can do it in any order you want, but this is what helps me. All right, so I'm just going to put a little strand of glue across the center. And glue the bow in the center. Okay, and that's what it looks like. All right, now we're almost finished. We're going to take our two felt pieces, and before you glue them in, and this is what helps out with the bow being in the center first, you just kind of place them back here, and it actually kind of holds them in place, and you kind of judge where you want them. Okay. And, you know, of course you can play around with it a little bit. Okay. And once you're satisfied with your, you know, with the way it looks, then you can just simply glue them in. Okay. And I might take that one out. Pull this up a little bit. I'm going to pull my loop back. I'm going to put a little bit of glue in there. And you can just leave the ear in and place it. Okay, so there's my first Minnie Mouse ear. I don't know if you can hear my dog snoring in the back. All right, I'm gonna pull that loop up and kind of put that little ear in and see. Just kind of do a once over. Okay. And then I'm going to just kind of hold that ear right there. You can do that as well. You can leave the ear so you don't have to take it out to glue it. Just put a little glue behind the ear. And voila. You've got a cute little Minnie Mouse bow to go with an outfit. You know, a dress, or, you know, there are lots and lots of cute little Minnie Mouse outfits out. You could actually do pink, that hot pink, or whatever color. You know, this is just the traditional red. And then you have your little clip on the back, and you're ready to go. And you can certainly make a bigger one. This is just 1.5 inch grosgrain. You can get 2 1/4 inch. I've made some bigger ones like that. Okay. Too cute. Minnie Mouse is very popular right now. Makes a good gift. And it was, you know, it's real simple. And you can do this, the ears and the bow, to any type of bow. It doesn't have to be a cheer bow. Okay, I've done them to pinwheels and, you know, several others. Okay. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Please subscribe to my channel and give me a thumbs up. And, please leave me a comment and let me know if there's anything else you'd like me to do a tutorial on. I have a running list right now, and I've had a few suggestions, so I definitely want to, you know, make some more. I can make just about anything, I believe, so just let me know, and thank you so much for watching. I am going to do some giveaways, so if you subscribe, once I get to a certain amount, I'm going to do some giveaways for that. So, y'all have a nice day, and thanks for watching.